The reigning Big Ten regular season champs have returned to East Lansing as the Michigan State Spartans and the Iowa Hawkeyes get ready to face off here on Big Ten Plus. Hello, everyone. I'm Maren Klein. Alongside me, my partner for today, Layla Pascal. And Layla, we have a really exciting meet here at Jennison Fieldhouse today with both these teams ranked in the top 20, Michigan State sitting at 14, Iowa right at 20. And this will be the Spartans' sixth ranked opponent so far this season.
Absolutely. And it's Iowa's second ranked opponent, so they have a lot of catching up to do. We currently have five Big Ten teams on the way to nationals ranked in the top 20, including Michigan, Ohio State, Michigan State, Minnesota, and Iowa.
Absolutely, a lot of talent stacked up and down in this conference. But now looking over at individual talent, a gymnast for the Hawkeyes has really been making a name for herself, Karina Munoz. She had first place on beam in their conference opener against Minnesota, and just this past Friday got second place on vault against Southern Utah.
Munoz scored against Southern Utah in their last meet a 9.775 on the beam and got the second highest vault score that night with a 9.825, as she is the Big Ten gymnast to watch.
Definitely an impressive performance from Munoz. And speaking of impressive performances, a gymnast that always makes a memorable performance for Michigan State is Skyla Schulte. Schulte put up season highs in both beam and bars in their conference opener against Penn State, and that performance earned her Big Ten Gymnast of the Week.
Schulte almost got a perfect 10 on the beam, bringing attention to it when she scored a 9.95 against Penn State.
She'll be looking to maybe get that perfect score tonight and set some more records here in their home opener. We're going to get you down to the floor shortly, but first we're going to send you to the third and fourth members of our team, Owen Ozust and Lexi Alston, who have a little bit more on some award-winning gymnasts putting up some big performances.
Thanks, guys. There's been so many incredible gymnasts over the last 50 years, and now in order to celebrate Team 50, a special logo was created, and what makes this so unique is that each element means something.
Yeah, take a look at the logo. At the top, that's for the entrance of Jennison Fieldhouse. Get a look at the bottom. Those little rhinestones are for the 50 leotards for the 50 teams here at Michigan State. Get a look at that middle and the banner. That's for the growth of the program over time, and then at the bottom right there, that is for the first ever Big Ten championship in school history. And Team 48, it really got things started for Michigan State. Team 49 was champs, and Team 50 is trying to take it to a whole nother level.
It's also Alumni Day here in Jennison Fieldhouse, and we'll get the chance to talk to some of those alum and bring you more on that later coming up on Big Ten Plus.
And welcome into a packed Jennison Fieldhouse for Michigan State's home opener versus the Hawkeyes. Again, I'm Maren Klein alongside Layla Pascal as we are gearing up for this one here today. Michigan State will be starting on the vault with Iowa on the uneven parallel bars.
Yep, we have an absolutely great broadcast ahead. These girls have been practicing extremely hard, extremely well. We've had a couple chances to talk with Coach Mike Rowe about MSU's opportunities today with some new skills that they're gonna possibly show out on floor and bars tonight.
So we'll take a look at that competition order. Iowa starting at bars, then to vault, floor, and beam. Michigan State, vault, bars, beam, and floor for them today. And Layla, I know you talked with Coach Rowe about some plans he has in enhancing some of these skills that the girls are working on.
Yeah, so Coach Mike Rowe said that he's looking to bring back beam to where it's been and up to the top again. And last week, we really saw that against Penn State with MSU taking that win on beam. And we're going to strive to see tonight their new skills, because they've really been focusing on how they're going to hit their landings, implement their new skills, and bring it all together with the dance movements.
So we'll take a look at the Iowa Hawkeyes bars competition order. Marissa Rojas, Kea Vanny, Ava Volpe, Gianna Masella, Ilika Juck, and Karina Munoz in that final order on the bars. Talked about Munoz a bit in our open. A lot of talented gymnasts on bars for the Hawkeyes.
Yep, Marissa Rojos, she's competed 11 out of 12 meets this far this season. So we're gonna see what she has to bring. She's got a career best of a 9.852 on the bars.
Now we're gonna take a look at the Spartans vault order. Skyla Schulte opening it up. Kayla Tucker, Gabby Ortiz, Gabby Steven, Nikki Smith, and Sage Kellerman. Actually, looks like Coach Rowe did make a switch, and Michaela Tucker taking that second spot with Walsh and Sawyer exhibition vaulting. Today for Michigan State, just about 20 seconds until this first rotation is underway. Michigan State will be starting with Skyla Schulte on the vault, doing a Yurchenko full. Penn State, she had a 9.85, her season high, and her first time on vault for that, for the season.
Her season high is a 9.925, and hopefully Schulte will be able to take home a 10 tonight.
So we will take a look at MSU head coach Mike Rowe. A lot of success with the Spartans. Yep. He said the Big Ten regular season champs of 2023.
And Coach Rowe is also talking about how, you know, there's a huge team this year. We have 23 girls, and usually you can only travel with 18. So his main focus is to get all the girls in as he can per meet into rotation and really take that time to hone in on everyone's skills on the team.
As we'll take a look at the Hawkeyes head coach here. As we are getting underway at Jennison Fieldhouse to start this one off, Skyla Schulte starting on vault for Michigan State and Marissa Rojas on uneven bars. We said Schulte during that Yurchenko full.
We've got an excellent start running in.
And a beautiful landing from Skyla Schulte, small hop back.
That might cost her a 10th, but ultimately she really kept her feet together and landed in line, so hopefully we'll see a great score from her tonight.
We saw yesterday at practice, Schulte was really looking to work on that landing. Pretty solid landing, like we said. Small hop back, a small deduction possible there, but overall, really good vault as we'll head over to uneven bars now, taking a look at Rojas, getting ready for her switch.
Just did a great flip from high bar to low bar. Kip Kask up to standing. She's really gonna look like she's gonna nail this. She's keeping great composure. Oh, and a big hop. It could cost her that great score that they were looking for tonight, but I think the team looks very proud of her.
Let's take another look at Schulte's vault. Saw there that landing, the tiniest bit. Hop back there on the landing. But a strong start for Michigan State. Rojas, little unfortunate hop there on her dismount, but a strong bar routine for her. As now, Michaela Tucker for Michigan State with a Yurchenko 1.5. Penn State scored a 9.775.
Up for bars, we have Kaya Vanni. She's getting ready to do her launch, just warming up a bit, standing, talking to teammates.
Suppose gymnast waiting for the all clear to get started.
Both girls are looking like they're ready to salute, just getting in that mindset.
Take a look again at Bonnie. She had a 9.725 in their last meet versus Southern Utah. Looking to post a better score as now we are here getting underway on the vault with Tucker. And a beautiful landing there from Michaela Tucker. Small step forward there on that 1 foot. Otherwise, a beautiful vault there. Spartan starting off strong.
She kept her body nice and tight in the air, really getting that perfect twist. Feet were completely together just until the end. But ultimately, that's going to get her a really high score up there.
We'll head over to Kayavani on uneven bars. Nice start there for Vani, keeping those legs together, toes pointed.
It's really important on bars to make sure that your toes are pointed. It's such an intense movement, going from bar to bar, flying in the air through that, and really mastering a perfect stick handstand to get into your giants, which right now she's doing great on with a double layout, but a big hop back and a step that could cost her up to 2/10 deduction, possibly even 3.
Like you said, Iowa looking really strong on those bar routines, just still struggling a little bit on the dismount as we see scores coming in for Skyla Schulte. She got a 9.85. And Tucker with a 9.875, those first two vaults for Michigan State. On bars, Rojas, her score coming in at a 9.75 for Iowa. As Gabby Ortiz, freshman of the week, debuted at Penn State on beam, is now setting up for her vault. Setting up to do a Yurchenko 1.5, working hard on this in practice yesterday. A big hop forward there for Ortiz.
She had a great flip in the air. She got a great start getting into her hurdle to make it onto the table. She just took a big hop, and sometimes with that, we're unable to see that perfect score we want. But all these girls tonight have to start with at least a 9.4 to qualify in today's meet, and everyone's striving to get that 10. It's a big climb, getting 6/10 up there.
As now Ava Volpe, third in the competition order for Iowa on the bars. As Gabby Steven sets up for her vault for Michigan State.
It looks like Ava Volpe is about to start her routine on the uneven bars with the high bar, which is a more common start we're seeing as you advance in levels, getting up to compete in worlds, nationals, Olympic ranks.
So we see Kayavani's score coming in at a 9.725. That's the third in the competition order for the Hawkeyes. Get started on her bar routine. Nice straight legs there. And nice transition for Volpe. Volpe now preparing for her dismount. And she'll stick the landing, the smallest of a hop, but otherwise a spectacular performance by Ava Volpe.
She's absolutely killing it right now, and that dismount, that double layout into that perfect stick, that's gonna get her some real high points. She could even get a perfect 10 with that one. She kept her hands perfectly straight with her arms nice, no bending.
And Gabby Steven over on the vault sticks the landing on a Yurchenko full. A beautiful performance put up by Gabby Steven on the vault.
That was absolutely astonishing to see here today. Her highest vault career score is a 9.95, so hopefully that might get her that 10. That's what we're all looking to see today, is big scores. Hopefully everybody is really working and striving to get that 10, and we know that. We're seeing prep constantly. There's not a minute to breathe when you are in this competition. Your headspace is in, and it's work, work, work.
And speaking of 10s, we saw a perfect 10 from Sage Kellerman on vault to open up the season for the Spartans. All the Spartans performing highly
They're
in
having
that
a
area.
Great season.
as Gianna Masella getting ready for her uneven bars. We see Gabby Stevens' score comes in at a 9.925. That's going to be a new season high for Gabby Stevens.
That alone is a fantastic takeaway from tonight, even if we don't see that 10 from her.
Masella so far looking strong on the bars. Nice handstand there, getting ready for the dismount. And she will stick that landing. Paused a small hop to regain her balance there. But a beautiful landing and a beautiful bar routine for Gianna Masella.
Absolutely. She did get that stick. We all thought she was going to stick it and keep it. However, sometimes it's better to take one of those small hops or steps to ensure your score rather than falling.
Nikki Smith just completed her 1.5, had that foot come forward there at the end on the landing. But form coming off that block looked beautiful. Keeping her legs, arms together, just putting that foot forward there at the end, landing in the middle of the mat.
It's super important for vault to keep your hips straight because deductions will come off with the hip angles, and depending on how you land, you're really gonna want to be dead center of that table upon landing. And as for bars, it's all about sticking it at that final rotation and sequence out of the flip when you're doing your dismount.
We see Ava Volpe's score coming in at a 9.800. And her teammate Ilika Juck preparing to start her routine.
The girls are chalking up right now on vault. It's a powerful feeling when you know, this is what's keeping your grip, it's keeping you intact, and you're ready to step up to the plate when you start chalking up your feet and your hands.
Strong transition from Juck. Masella's score comes in at a 9.825. Preparing for that dismount. Nice turn.
Oh.
And fumbled a bit there on the landing.
Yep, she wasn't able to stick her double back out of that giant. She landed almost completely off the mat onto the fourth mats. But that step and that big of a hop, that's gonna possibly cost her a fifth tonight.
And we discussed Sage Kellerman has that perfect 10. The first meet of the season as she gets ready for her vault, a front pike half. Nikki Smith's score on the vault coming in at a 9.825 as Kellerman takes off. And she will stick that smallest hop backwards, but a beautiful vault from Sage Kellerman.
There's a little wiggle room with the collegiate deduction system as we're advancing in skills and climbing up those ranks, like as I said, to get into Worlds, Nationals, Olympic status. And so that might only just cost her a fifth of a tenth or a half a tenth, which will be wonders for her score as she is climbing to meet that max now every time of a 10. She has a big, big hurdle in Yurchenko, so they have to pull the springboard back for her because she's got a lot of room and a lot of heart, a lot of passion, and hopefully she's going to be able to secure a 10 tonight.
Karina Munoz, we talked about pre-game, now setting up for her bar routine.
She's going to start from the other side of the uneven bars, really keeping good form. It's definitely advanced skills to go straight into the top bar of the parallels.
So far looking strong.
Her form is almost perfect.
And a nice dismount. Saw that small hop there at the end. But like you said, Layla, almost perfect form on those bars for that routine for Karina Munoz.
She looks happy with it. It can be frustrating as a gymnast, not only taking one little hop, but two hops back. So hopefully she's happy with her score.
Tara Walsh on the vault. She will stick that landing.
Excellent form the entire time. Kept her body tight, hips aligned. She landed almost perfectly in line with the center of the table and stuck that landing perfectly with a great finish and salute. We might even see a 10 off of that.
And we see Kellerman's score coming in at a 9.9. Like you said, a very impressive performance there from Tara Walsh. Had the full.
So far, both teams are looking really happy with their scores. And I can't wait to see what the rest of the night, what that's going to look like for us as we keep moving.
Next, we will see Olivia Dilnicki as we'll take one more look at Walsh's vault. Beautiful form and a beautiful landing for Tara Walsh. You see the crowd exploding in applause there. A packed house here at Jennison Fieldhouse for the home opener. And Dilnicki, the last Hawkeye on the bars.
She didn't quite hit her handstand on that lower bar, and that will cost her. It also makes it more difficult for her because she can't get as much power and flow into the transitions with the releases. We also saw her hips slightly out of line there.
Trouble there on the dismount. And that will finish the Hawkeyes on the bars. Munoz's score coming in at a 9.8. And we will have one final Spartan, Katie Sawyer, with a full for Michigan State to finish off this first rotation.
Dilnicki just kind of saved herself on that landing, almost making it off the mat. That's going to cost her.
It's a nice vault, small hop back there for Sawyer. And we see Walsh's score as well, coming in at a 9.8. And that will finish off both teams for this first rotation. A strong rotation all in vault for Michigan State. Iowa, beautiful form on those bar routines. Had a little trouble there with the dismount.
Ultimately, the girls tonight, though, they're putting out their best. And right now, we're going to transition over to MSU on the uneven bars with Iowa coming to vault. We have a lot of strong vaulters on Iowa's team tonight for vaulting.
Michigan State currently leading now 49.375. Iowa just behind them at 48.900. So we wait for those final scores from that first rotation to come in.
A lot of gymnastics rules will be changing coming of the summer this year. I talked with Coach Mike Rowe about some of the regulations and how we're going to have some new distributions passed of them, really incorporating these higher ranked skills that we're seeing today with deduction points.
Now we're going to toss it down to the floor to our sideline reporters, Lexi and Owen, with coaches from either side.
I'm here with head coach Larissa Libby. Coach, what was your assessment of that first rotation?
Well, I think we're doing okay right now. We're just like six hits is kind of where we're looking for. This is our third meet in 6 days. So they're a little tired. So right now the focus is just on getting the first person up to be consistent and then to go with every consecutive person, just staying in the moment and then moving on. Just we have a tendency to get ahead of ourselves. So I felt like they did a good job. For the most part, interior is getting better. It's all landings right now.
Thank you so much, Coach. I don't want to keep you too long.
No, you're welcome.
Thank you. More gymnastics coming up here on Big Ten Plus.
Thank you.
Hello and welcome back into Jennison Fieldhouse. Michigan State leading 49.37. Iowa right behind them at 48.90 after that first rotation. As now Michigan State will head to the uneven bars and Iowa on to vault. Let's go take a look.
I'm excited to see what each girl has to bring. Watching them warm up right now. We got a lot of powerhouses on vault. Really running, taking off. And we have some great dismounts here.
As we look at the order for vault, Gianna Masella, Hannah Castillo, Avery Chambers, Elise Karenbauer, Ava Volpe, and finishing off with Karina Munoz, starting now with Gianna Masella. So we'll take a look at Michigan State on the bars. Gabby Stevens, Skyla Schulte, Jory Jackard, Sage Kellerman, Nikki Smith, and Delaney Harkness. Finishing up for Michigan State. Michaela Tucker and Kendall Abney for Michigan State will have exhibitions.
We're getting ready.
Gianna Masella setting up for her first vault. And a beautiful landing from Masella. You see the applause from her teammates. A great start for the Hawkeyes on vault.
They're thrilled, their celebration is so immaculate. High fives everywhere, fist pumps even. She really stuck that landing though beautifully, and hopefully her score does not reflect any news of a small little gap in the feet upon the landing. She kept good form. Her hips did over rotate a little, but she ultimately stuck it completely.
There's Gabby Steven on the bars. Season high of 9.875. Mike Rowe talked about adding some new harder moves to those uneven bar routines for his Spartans. She prepares for the dismount. And she will stick that almost perfect, stuck that left foot out there at the end just a bit, but a beautiful performance from Gabby Steven to start off Michigan State on bars.
That was a beautiful, beautiful routine. It takes a lot of work to be able to have yourself launching like that, bar to bar, doing your releases, getting back up, and the height that she got upon her dismount was unreal.
Hannah Castillo setting up for her vault. And a beautiful landing. Went back just a touch there.
The smallest little skip, hop, step, and jump, that can affect your score greatly. But it's looking like she's going to score really high with that.
So we see Skyla Schulte setting up for her uneven bar routine. Gianna Masella's score comes in for vault, scoring a 9.825.
I know she was definitely looking to score higher than that, but that small step can cost you, and you got to make sure your arms are super tight, which is incredibly hard to do, but that's what these girls are in the gym for almost every single day, preparing for warm-ups, cardio, conditioning.
You see Gabby Stevens. No score yet in for Gabby Steven and Skyla Schulte preparing for her routine on the bars. Beautiful transition to start off for Schulte and right back to that lower bar. Great form for the Spartan preparing for her dismount. And a great landing there from Schulte. Jennison erupting in applause. A small hop forward there, but an otherwise flawless routine by Skyla Schulte.
Watching that replay right now, you can see how she keeps her legs straight. Her toes are pointed in the beginning. They do flex a little at the end, and that might cause a little bit of disruption.
It's Avery Chambers for her vault for the Hawkeyes. sticks the landing. Avery Chambers.
Her feet and legs together the entire time. She almost cut it a little short there, landing fairly close to the table, but she kept perfect form. She's starting off with an amazing vault run, a great hurdle into it, and she was able to pull out a fantastic performance. Hopefully that will reflect a 10 for her.
Chambers, her last time out on vault, scored a 9.775. Vault she just completed, looking like it might have a bit of a higher score. As Castillo's vault score comes in for the Hawkeyes, scoring a 9.800. Gabby Stevens' bar score for Michigan State coming in at a 9.825. As Jory Jackard for Michigan State gets ready for her bar routine. Jackard got her season high at Penn State with a 9.875.
Jackard only is performing with her career highs with a bars 10, and on beam she has a 9.775, so hopefully tonight we'll see the 10s come out and really put forth what they're working on individually with each girl to make them well-rounded gymnasts.
Jackard now beginning her routine, starting on that high bar. Nice handstand. Beautiful execution there for Jackard. On her transition, team cheering her along. She does that final handstand preparing for her dismount. And sticking the landing, Jory Jackard.
Absolute beautiful release into that dismount. She kept great motion, great movement, nice and tight body. We're gonna see that here on the replay. A beautiful double tuck. You can tell she really caught herself. She did lean forward slightly.
And Elise Karenbauer for the Hawkeyes on that vault. Good form, bit of a big hop there on her landing.
She had a super strong run, and sometimes when we see when you have that kind of power going into your Yurchenko, into your skill, that you can over-rotate or under-rotate and not be as tight as you want to, so it's really finding that balance.
It's now Sage Kellerman for Michigan State setting up for her bar routine. Kellerman, just like Jackard, posted a 9.875 season high at Penn State.
We're watching the girls get ready to go. A little bit of a warm-up to set up that Yurchenko.
Some issues seen at the scoring table for MSU right now. Only Gabby Stevens' bar score in. It's their fourth gymnast in the competition order for bars. Starts her routine.
An excellent release and catch.
From Jackard. Now going into that final handstand, nice straight legs, preparing for the dismount. And Jackard, a nice landing, that right foot poking out a little bit there at the end. But another strong performance on the uneven bars for Michigan State.
She hit a very perfect straight handstand before going into her giants. That will bring up her difficulty level.
Ava Volpe with a beautiful landing there on her vault coming from the Yurchenko.
Unfortunately, she did take a little bit of a hop. it's not common tonight that we've seen so far any lot of perfect sticks on that landing. So hopefully, as these girls are preparing, they're having their landings in their head, they're seeing past the table on vault.
So we see scores coming in for Michigan State on bars. Skyla Schulte tying her season high with a 9.9. Jory Jackard a 9.825. As Nikki Smith prepares for her bar routine.
Watching these girls in practice the other day, seeing them really work on these routines, we know that they're coming in from Michigan State fully prepared to dominate and try to secure this win for them.
Last time out on bars at Penn State, Smith had a 9.775, her season high, 9.925. A bit of trouble with the routine at Penn State, looking to change that score. Starting off very strong, good transition.
The issue that we'll see, though, is if you hold up on that handstand too long to get your framing, sometimes that can cost you time-wise.
Smith preparing for her dismount. And a beautiful landing, the tiniest hop backwards, and almost a perfect stick for Nikki Smith.
She's definitely gonna score high on that beginning handstand on the lower parallel bar. As she adjusted to catch herself, that might cost her.
Karina Munoz on that vault, a big hop back. And points deducted from that.
And a large arm swing too, you can get up to 2/10 of a deduction when your arms aren't sticking by your side or in the air when you're trying to catch yourself.
This looks like Ava Volpe's score came in at a 9.8. As next up for Michigan State, Delaney Harkness on the bars, a season high of 9.50. So has almost had that perfect score on the bars. So the Hawkeyes are done with their second rotation. All their gymnasts have gone through the vault, Michigan State with Harkness, and then Tucker and Abney with exhibition routines.
As I was saying earlier, with such a large team, you're able to place girls into the rotation, really get that advantage to bring up your score.
Harkness starting on that high bar. Nice catch and release. Going into that transition, beautiful from Delaney Harkness. To finish out with a strong dismount. And she will stick that landing, feet just a little bit apart, but otherwise a perfect stick for Delaney Harkness.
Coach is happy. You can see how he stood by the bars just in case, as we're working on new skills, as they were mentioned in practice beforehand. And we're seeing the results of that. Hopefully that will get a high score, as it was almost flawless.
Spartans with a very strong performance. On the bars, you see scores rolling in. Smith with a 9.85 for her routine. Looks like Kellerman got a 9.8. As we'll go in to exhibitions, coming from Tucker and Abney. Tucker, last time out, saw a 9.775.
So far, we're seeing a lot of powerhouse gymnasts, and sometimes that's the best to be. Whereas when you're competing on floor, you want to have more of a lyrical standpoint, get into your routine and that rhythm. So as we finish up bars here, we're going to see that power and possibly transition into the flow of the choreography and incorporating those skills and those passes.
Kayla Tucker starting off her routine.
Her arms are remaining nice and straight. A small bend when in her release, but hopefully that won't take off too many deduction points.
It's on the dismount. She will stick that landing as well.
Her feet were slightly separated in the landing. However, it was a perfect stick. We're not going to see a perfect 10 from that routine, but it will definitely score high and hopefully lock her in to a great position to place at the end of the night.
As we have just one more exhibition from Kendall Abney for the Spartans before heading to that third rotation, Michigan State will be on the balance beam and Iowa on the floor. Looks like Delaney Harkness got a 9.9 for her bar routine. Same score she had in Penn State.
Ultimately tonight, if you can't score a 10, it's great to walk away with a new career high, a personal best. And we're seeing these girls fight for that.
Right now for this rotation, Michigan State 49.300. Iowa just behind them, 49.001, bringing the total scores to 98.675 and 98 even. As Abney starts her exhibition routine.
Incredible form right now from hands to toes on bars.
She'll get the dismount. Small hop back, but a beautiful landing and a great exhibition routine from Kendall Abney.
Technicalities wise, nearly flawless. I think they're all gonna expect to see about a 9.85 minimum for that routine.
So Michigan State, another strong performance. The Hawkeyes doing well on the bars. Behind Michigan State by a slim margin. So we look at the scores from the Hawkeyes vault. Masilla with a 9.825, Castillo the 9.8, Chambers 9.875, Karen Bauer 9.8, Volpe 9.8, and Munoz with a 9.775, all great scores. Both teams having a really strong second rotation.
Now we're gonna take a look at the bar scores.
Bar scores for Michigan State, Gabby Steven, a 9.825, Schulte, 9.9, great performance by Skyla Schulte. Jory Jackard, 9.825, 9.8 for Kellerman. Smith with a 9.85, and Harkness, 9.8. Two really strong performances there, like we said, in that second rotation. Heading into the third, Michigan State will be on the beam, Iowa on the floor. And we're gonna send it down to Owen Ozis on the floor with head coach Mike Rowe from Michigan State.
Thanks, guys. Coach, we talked about earlier in the week how good you guys were at bars. What's your assessment from today?
We are good. We kind of showed it today, but a little disappointed in some of the stuck landings. It's not gonna hurt us, but you know, further down the road, we gotta get a little more consistent on that. So two or three, maybe all of them. We're gonna be good. We're right in there. I'm really proud of what they've accomplished so far. Great, great, great start on vault for us. I'm really excited about today.
What do you guys need to do to finish this one out strong?
We gotta drop, forget about vault, forget about bars, go to beam and just be laser focused and do what they're capable of doing in practice every day. We'll be all right.
Thanks, coach. Thank you. All right, we're gonna send it to break, and then when we come back, we'll have more action here on Big Ten Plus.
And we're gonna send it down to Owen, standing by with an MSU gymnast on the floor.
Thanks, guys. I'm here with, it's Alumni Day here at Michigan State. Now, obviously, 50 years of MSU gymnastics. What does it mean to be alumni here at MSU?
It's awesome to be back, of course. Every time I come, there's always a nostalgia in that, and I very much enjoy being here. 50 years is kind of incredible. Somewhat makes me feel old. Somewhat, you know, just brings joy that the program's been going strong this long. And it's awesome to be able to come and support them.
What does Michigan State Gymnastics mean to you? Obviously, you're big in bringing back the alumni and everything like that. What does it mean to you?
Michigan State Gymnastics has my heart. I loved every moment I was here. There'll always be a special place for me in this building, in this arena, with my teammates. So I couldn't trade any of those moments for life. They were fantastic for me.
And you're still one of the whole record holders for floor here at Michigan State. Is there anyone that you think on this team could potentially beat you?
I would love to see someone beat me, actually. There are a few that have potential to. I think Skyla, Delaney, Naya or Nikki, they are lots of talent. The depth for them is fantastic. So bring it on. I would love for somebody to beat that record for me.
What does it mean to come back here to Jensen Fieldhouse, where you were runners-up for the 2006 Big Ten Championships?
Yeah, that is my favorite moment of my career, being here at home and being able to get second place at Big Tens itself. So excited for them last year to have been in that same position, to be able to be second place in Big Tens. We want to obviously strive for first place too, but it's awesome to see records being broken, the program continuing to gain momentum and to get stronger and stronger as the years go.
Awesome. Thank you so much. Enjoy the rest of your day. And then now we got floor coming up right after the break.
Thank you so much for that, Owen. Exciting to have alumni back here at Jennison Fieldhouse for the home opener. It's Michigan State setting up for beam competition order. Gianna Khalifi, Michaela Tucker, Gabby Ortiz, Skyla Schulte, Bailey Garcia, and Gabby Steven. Finishing for the Spartans now on the floor for the Hawkeyes. Going to see Alex Ebling, Ava Volpe, Elise Karenbauer, Emily Erb, Hannah Castillo, and Bailey Libby. Michigan State again will have two exhibitions from Naomi German and Kendall Abney on the beam. And Layla, I know you talked to Coach Rowe about how he wants to see those beam scores getting up to what they once were.
Absolutely. Right now, they're changing their conditioning for floor and beam almost every month, if not a little sooner on the month, and adding new warm-ups into conditioning so that their bodies are nice and fluid and they're getting max amount of potential. What we're seeing on these routines today will reflect their changes. They're getting more creative these days in general in gymnastics with how you warm up and with how you condition, adding smaller weights, bigger weights, variations of things. Back in the day, it used to just be some push-ups, pull-ups, but as it's progressed, we've added leg lifts, rope climbs up and down, and now to the point where we're doing so much more in advancement.
So we see Gianna Khalifi setting up for her routine on the beam. Penn State tied her season high of a 9.85. She's getting chalked up and ready to go. Michigan State really working on those beam routines. As we wait to get underway, Khalifi gives the salute and gets ready to start a routine.
A beautiful mount onto the beam right there. The technicality of that brings up your score level so much. And as a lot of the girls today from Michigan State are starting with routines at a minimum of a 9.85, and there a lot of starts are trying to start at a 10, so that does make it a little risky in keeping a perfect routine to keep that 10 rather than build up to it. But Coach Rowe has the confidence in their girls, and I have the confidence up here from the view.
Good job by Khalifi to keep her balance there on those landings. Not struggle for too long and get any points deducted. the longer you spend keeping your balance on that beam after a move, points will be deducted. She gets ready for the dismount. And a perfect stick from Gianna Khalifi. What a way to start off this rotation for the Spartans.
Feet separated just a little bit on that landing. We're probably going to see a 9.8, 9.7 on that beam routine, but it's a great start for Michigan State in the meet for beam and floor rotations.
As we get ready for floor, Alexa Ebling starting it off for the first floor routine for the Hawkeyes. Always a lot of fun watching these floor routines. A lot of great choreography in NCAA gymnastics.
We also get to hear some great music from the floor routines. The girls get super creative. It's crafted and catered from their favorite songs, their skill level, and their coaches and choreographers really help bring it to life, their personalities, as floor is the chance to showcase what you bring to the table as a gymnast through all of the dance moves and through all the challenging skills and passes.
So Evelyn getting ready. Had a 9.8 in the meet on Friday against Southern Utah. Her floor routine.
Her team's cheering them on, and that's always great to go. Getting into that mindset. Sometimes it can be a little distracting, but once you work with a team for so long, then you're enjoying every second.
Order switched up a bit, and Volpe will be starting off with her floor routine first. Looks like some troubles with the music causing this delay. Just waiting, and as I said, Ava Volpe will be starting off floor routine, switching around the order.
They won't be shaken though by this delay. They're trained for this, and you know, it's just an extra opportunity to really get your head in that mindset of executing a perfect routine. On the floor is where we can see all of those small technicalities and physique movements that could cost you a deduction or bring up your score.
And heard just moments ago, let's go Hawks chant. Hawkeyes fans traveling to East Lansing to support the team. Like you said, Fulby doing a good job not letting any delays get into her head too much as we still wait for this music delay to be fixed. She's keeping warm. Always fun to watch these routines too when you're around your team for so long and practicing the same routine weeks and weeks on end. You always see teammates on the side doing those moves just right along with them. Something always so fun about gymnastics. As we see that salute, and Volpe is ready to begin her routine.
Great thing about floor two is when the music comes on, it gets the whole crowd cheering. We're gonna see her first pass right now. She did a good job with sticking it, a small step. Hitting those poses and being fluid out of a path into the choreography is key to getting a good score on the floor.
Especially on that floor routine, showing emotion, having fun with it, something the judges always like to see. You can see Volpe getting into the music.
She had an excellent split leap, a side leap there, a nice switch. She's gonna get ready for her second pass.
Volpe going now for her second pass. And a nice landing there. Stuck that foot back, making sure to keep it in bounds.
It was a beautiful round off backhand spring into a double back.
And Volpe did not let that delay phase her. A great floor routine to get the Hawkeyes started off on this rotation. And now we'll head back over to the beam. Michaela Tucker getting ready to go for Michigan State as we take another look at that pass from Volpe.
She seems so happy with it. You could tell. Big smile on her face.
In an exhibition at Penn State, Tucker scored a 9.8 on the beam. A really strong performance. An exhibition match, so not counted toward the team's points, but she'll be second in the order. First move. A beautiful landing there, going right into the backhand spring, staying completely balanced.
Right now, she's looking super fluid. This is exactly what Coach Rowe wanted. Excellent execution, bringing beam back to the top. Right now, MSU is striving with bars and vaults. They feel very confident and secure in that. They feel good with their floor, but beam's been a bit of a concern so far this season. No one would be able to tell. We have excellent landings and sticks through these flips and passes. You're required a certain amount of leaps at this level on the beam and a certain amount of tumbling passes across. And right now, she's hitting every single one of them excellently.
Yeah, Tucker doing a great job at hitting each mark, keeping that balance on every move. She prepares to finish it off here in a beautiful landing. That foot just a little bit out of place. But otherwise, what a great routine from Michaela Tucker for Michigan State.
Absolutely flawless. I know that that's been worked on a lot. So I bet Coach and the whole team is feeling incredibly proud right now as they're celebrating. It ties all back in with their conditioning and how they're adding a lot of calisthenics to work on that balance instead of just lifting and getting that muscle.
Here's Alexa Ebling now for her floor routine. Back over beam. Gianna Califi's score comes in at a 9.825. It's a bit of a slower song here. A first pass coming from Ebling. A lot of height. Struggled a little bit on that landing, but kept her composure.
It was slightly under-rotated, and that's what's going to cut it for you. Because once you're leaning forward, if you under-rotate, you're going to have to catch yourself in a way that you don't intend.
Now for her second pass. Very nice landing there, sticking that. Covering from that first landing off the first pass.
Absolutely beautiful. And with those extra mats on the floor to secure the safest possible landing when elevating skills that you haven't gotten used to 100% competing with, it can also affect and make your routine more challenging if you're slightly out of line or needing to cross back over one of those mats. And she moved through it beautifully.
Going for that third pass now. A lot of height and went down, didn't get that landing.
That's gonna be a whole point off her routine. She finished strong, had to keep her composure. You can't let it affect you when you have those steps or big falls like that as you have a routine to finish out with and you're still trying to strive for the best score that you possibly can get.
Yeah, Ebling did a good job at getting right back up there and finishing off her routine strong. Never a good thing after that happens and you get that fall, but did a great job. Keeping your composure, getting right back up after that, got a lot of height there and just on there on her first pass as Gabby Ortiz on the beam for Michigan State. Tied her season high with a 9.875 at Penn State last weekend.
She had a simple mount, but sometimes simple and clean is the best way to score high, especially when you know you have a big routine ahead.
Tucker's score came in on the beam at a 9.75.
An absolutely stellar, stunning backhand spring step out into a back layout step out. We have the two leaps hit right there. She was able to keep her balance. She stayed super tight, and that's gonna keep her score intact.
A reason she was named as Big Ten Freshman of the Week. She's had a really strong start to her collegiate career. She'll go for the dismount and stick it.
The smallest hop at the end. You need to hold that steady, but a perfect landing up until right then. She seems thrilled with her routine, and all of the crowd is also thrilled with watching that.
You can see a big smile on the freshman's faces. Get another look at that dismount. Like you said, tiny hop there at the end, but otherwise a great dismount. See the smiles from Ortiz and her whole team.
As a freshman, too, start with such a high skill difficulty competing in your first year, it's only up from here. We're hoping to see a lot of these girls make it further than their collegiate careers.
Elise Karenbauer on the floor now for the Hawkeyes, had a 9.875 on Friday against Southern Utah.
Karenbauer is in fact a powerhouse. She's getting ready with her first pass.
Beautiful landing there to start off after the first pass.
Incredible how she kept her body so tight while in her twists. As I was mentioning earlier, floor routines is where your personality shines. She is a power gymnast. And sometimes that can be hard on floor when your movements perhaps aren't considered as lyrical and rhythmical. With that being said, though, she's lighting a fire under the crowds. And so far, is going to score very high if she keeps it up like this.
As those first two scores from Iowa came in, Polpe with a 9.775, Ebling with a 9.125 after that fall on her third pass. Hawkeyes looking to score high here as Karenbauer goes for the second pass. And a nice landing.
A beautiful
small stumble.
A beautiful front tuck into that round off, into that final rotation. That's gonna really bring up her score level and difficulty.
Just the kind of routine the Hawkeyes need after that fall from Ebling. Take another look at that here.
A front step out, round off, double back right there. You can tell just by the way she finished her routine that she felt strong in that. And it's difficult these days with the movement and rule changes and regulation to max out on that 10 opportunity.
Skyla Schulte had a season high at Penn State on the beam with a 9.95. Almost a perfect score.
Excellent turn right there. Keeping her body super tight, toes excellently pointed. We have our first leap, into a switch jump. Schulte plays the role of both a power gymnast and a lyrical one, and you can see that on her beam routine.
Perfect balance there.
It's crucial that when you stick those landings, you don't have any movement from your shoulders or your wrists. And that might be a perfect 10 on beam with that landing right there. Feet were together. She stuck it beautifully, nice and tight.
A beautiful stick there from Schulte. You said Coach Mike Rowe really working on getting those beam routines up, and they've looked strong so far as Ortiz's score comes in at a 9.825, and see Schulte, perfect balance there. Look at that dismount, keeping the legs tight, sticking the landing, a small bend there in one of her knees, but otherwise a dominant performance from Skyla Schulte as we take a look at Emily Erb for the Hawkeyes starting her floor routine.
I do love the power routines. They have a lot of personality, and they're usually incredibly unique.
Erb against Southern Utah had a 9.85, setting up for her first pass. And a beautiful landing.
Almost stuck perfectly. There was the smallest bounce, which they might take a tenth off for. She is getting into it, and her teammates are with her. Two beautiful straddles right there. You can see how high her legs come up, and a lot of flexibility in that range. Hip mobility is a critical part in tumbling passes.
Now she goes for her second pass. Going to stay strong with another strong landing. She'll get a small stumble there. But beautiful form, and she'll finish that one out. That was another strong floor routine the Hawkeyes needed.
Absolutely astonishing. The two double twists back-to-back is such a hard skill to do. To see her execute it just with the smallest step out of that landing is impeccable.
Bailey Garcia now up for Michigan State. Penn State got her season high of a 9.9. Looking to continue the Spartans' strong performance so far on beam. Starting out with a nice turn, keeping her balance.
These girls have incredibly strong legs to be able to propel themselves off the beam as it has no buoyancy in executing and helping them do their passes.
She'll set up for another pass here. Nice aerial. Keeps her balance into the split. Two more jumps, keeping her composure perfectly. As we see
hitting.
Schulte's score came in as a 9.9. She'll go for the dismount. And a beautiful dismount there. Had that hop wasn't perfectly straight up, had to hop forward just a bit. But otherwise, a really great routine coming from Garcia.
When your chest lands forward like that, means you're under rotating. You're gonna have to keep yourself stuck tight, and that will cost her a tenth.
Hannah Castillo now starting her floor routine for Iowa. As we see Erb on her floor routine got a 9.9, the type of score the Hawkeyes were looking for. She'll go for her first pass. Chest a little too far forward, had a small hop there on the landing.
You can ultimately see, though, that that is a long-term skill to work on as you're doing not just one, not two, but five pass movements.
You said earlier, Layla, a lot of these gymnasts working on some really high-level skills. When that is the case, the judges will sometimes be a bit more lenient. As she executed the pass great, just chest went a little too far forward as she goes for her second pass now. And she'll get a nice landing on that. Feet together, hopped a little bit after. But a great routine coming from Castillo.
A lot of girls' focuses when they talk to their coach is finding out what is the best move for the day of the meet. When they're in warm-ups beforehand, they tend to discuss, should we implement our new skill or strive for that higher score, depending on how warm-ups are looking, so that they can maximize their potential career highs.
Gabby Steven now on the beam for Michigan State.
A pike jump to the beam as a mount. Incredibly unique right there. These girls 100% want to stand out, and they are doing it.
Steven at Penn State, tied season high with a 9.87. A beautiful landing there on that pass.
These girls work constantly on their turns on beams, their steps, their landings, but sometimes the tiniest turn can turn around your score. So when you see a gymnast twist, oh my, she did catch herself. Sometimes catching yourself on the beam will cost you more points, since the longer you wobble, the more your leg sticks out and lifts off the beam. They're taking it 10th by 10th. You have to make sure, you have to be careful that if you're gonna save yourself how she just did, that it's not gonna add up to a full point.
But a great dismount as Steven sticks that landing. Points, like you said, will be deducted for that wobble, but did a great job at keeping her composure, finishing out her beam routine, getting a really solid landing.
That's exactly what we were discussing earlier. It's hard not to get frazzled when you're in that headspace of, oh no, did I just make a big mistake? I almost had it perfect, to get back in and to finish it out perfectly.
Bailey Libby now, her first pass on her floor routine, and a beautiful landing.
You can see she's got a lot of spunk. We're gonna see that energy in her tumbling passes.
The Hawkeyes have done a great job at really keeping the energy in these floor routines, showing those personalities, like you said, always so important. On the floor is her second pass, and another beautiful landing for Bailey Libby. A really strong floor routine so far.
Going from that twist into that layout, incredibly difficult, and you're going to see that reflect in her score positively. The music's changing up a bit, so you can see her more lyrical side. There's a lot of funk and spunk. Everybody's thoroughly enjoying it.
Saw the change in pace there. She'll go for her third pass. That one got caught up a little bit on the landing.
When your feet get out of place like that and you take a small step behind, it's gonna cost you. But ultimately, we haven't seen that move yet tonight. The front handspring into the twist.
So, a really good way to finish out that third rotation for the Hawkeyes. So we'll head to the exhibition. Gymnast on beam, Naomi German, up first for Michigan State. Lost balance just a second there the spin, but kept her composure.
As I was saying, those turns, you learned that as a level 2, level 3 gymnast. but they're going to come and sneak up on you, really making sure that you keep your composure and that you keep your basic skills as you're advancing.
German Interlaxis Exhibition had a 9.550. She lost her footing there for a second, leg stuck out.
A small wobble will only cost you a half tenth or a tenth of a deduction. However, when the leg comes out, it's two tenths off.
But a very nice landing to finish it up for Naomi German. Small hop backwards on that exhibition routine.
She finished strong, though, and this is what Coach is talking about, really trying to advance those beam skills, but keeping it to where they can score high in competition.
As Michigan State, the last exhibition gymnast up, Kendall Abney, on her exhibition on the beam, before the third rotation finishes out, see fist bumps with teammate Skyla Schulte. Bit of a pep talk there for Abney. Always good to see the team chemistry alive and well for both these sides. You see it so much in gymnastics. It's such an important thing. While it may be individual events, being together as a team is one of the most important things.
Absolutely. I remember when I used to do gymnastics, we'd have gym sleepovers. We'd all work out together, eat together, sleep over, and start it up in the morning.
Both very tight-knit teams. So we see the score from Garcia's exhibition was a 9.6. And Abney sets up for this final routine of the third rotation. Michigan State's currently leading 147.775. Iowa right behind them at 146.925. Setting up for a spin. Really good job. A lot of rotations there. She kept her balance and was able to land perfectly on that beam.
It's incredibly difficult to perform that skill, making 2.5 turns.
And a beautiful landing there off that pass.
It's incredibly difficult to have such great sticks as these girls have tonight on the beam, as a beam is smaller than an iPhone.
And you see the high level of skills, even in these exhibition routines. Coach Mike Rowe, like you said, really working on getting some higher beam scores, and Spartans have done very well with that so far tonight.
There was the smallest wobble before her turn. She's not letting it faze her.
She'll go for that dismount, and a nice landing. Feet were a bit apart, but no steps back. She'll stick it.
An aerial into the twist. Astonishing. The smallest step can affect your score without one wobble, but that might be their highest scoring beam routine of the night.
So the Spartans were really looking up to bring up those beam scores. They did now, leading 147.775. Iowa behind them at 146.925. Two really strong performances now. Going to switch as Michigan State heads to the floor. New choreographer this year for Michigan State. But we'll take a look at those beam scores. Khalifi with a 9.825. Tucker 9.775. Ortiz 9.825. Schulte with a 9.9. Garcia 9.775. And Steven finishing it out with a 9.75. Hawkeyes
on the floor doing very well. Well, a few stumbles and that one fall, but other than that, some really strong performances coming from the Hawkeyes. You see Ebling had that fall, got the 9.125. Volpe, 9.775. Karen Bauer, 9.725. We saw that amazing performance from Emily Erb, got the 9.9. Castillo with a 9.65. And finishing it off, Libby with a 9.875. As we get ready to head into this final rotation.
I'm incredibly excited to see Michigan State's floor routines. As you said, Marin, they did get a new choreographer. I had the opportunity to discuss with Coach Mike and some of the assistant coaches how that will affect tonight. New skills are being presented.
So like you said, new choreographer, new skills for the Spartans, working hard, and we will head over to the fourth rotation soon. You're watching gymnastics on Big Ten Plus. Back into Jennison Fieldhouse, Michigan State leading 147.775 to 146.925. As we head in to the fourth and final rotation, if you look at the competition order on beam for the Hawkeyes, Ava Volpe, Alexa Ebling, Ilika Juck, Avery Nick, Marissa Rojas, and Karina Munoz. Now looking over the Spartans on the floor, Ellie Buffet, Michaela Tucker, Gabby Steven, Delaney Harkness, Nikki Smith, and Skyla Schulte. Exhibitions coming from Gianna Khalifi and Gabby Ortiz. Like we mentioned just before the break, Layla, Michigan State with a new choreographer this year, seeing some new moves from the Spartans with some really high-level skills coming. So we look at the last rotation performances from Emily Erb with a 9.9 on her routine, and Skyla Schulte also a 9.9.
We saw some incredible passes. Groups are huddling up, getting ready to finish out this meet with our new choreographer for Michigan State. We see also some more rhythmic movements, a little bit more of dance routines. Really leading the Spartans to have a good rotation.
Floor routines, like we said, always known for showing that personality, and the Spartans, a lot of personality from all these girls. They really love doing those floor routines, having a lot of fun with it.
Coach Rowe has been sure to make it so all of their girls tonight should be starting with a 9.9 or a 10 starting score.
You see Ava Volpe starting her beam routine. First for the Hawkeyes. Volpe had a 9.75 on Friday versus Southern Utah. It's a nice landing there from Volpe.
Her shoulders twisted just in the slightest.
Bit of a stumble there off that first jump, but a recovery and sticking the landing on the second.
You can tell she's taking her time, making sure she's hitting everything and to not fall.
Nice landing on that aerial.
On beam, you only have about a minute to complete your routine.
And a great landing there from Volpe as Hawkeye team and fans erupt into applause. Feet just a bit separated, but no stumble there on the landing. She stayed nice and still.
It's definitely a high scoring beam routine. with just the smallest bit of wobbles.
Ellie Buffet starting off on floor for Michigan State. Going for her first pass. Bit of a bounce on that first landing.
It's hard to start out strong with a pass right into it. It doesn't give you as much time to prepare and grasp how much power you're going to need to take up that floor space.
As Buffet gets ready for her second pass.
A gorgeous walkover into the sequence of her pass.
And a great landing there from Buffet.
Kept her body perfectly tight during her twist into her layout.
We said seeing some more high-level skills coming from Michigan State on these routines.
This floor sequence, you can see the dance moves implicated to get that high score as well. You have to reach a certain amount of difficulty to reach a 9.910 start.
And another great landing on that third pass from Buffet to finish out her routine. And what a great start for Michigan State in this fourth rotation. Buffet, you can see her and her teammates clearly very happy with that start. A great level of skills and dance implemented. You saw how passionate she was throughout the routine. Season high is a 9.9 at Penn State, scored a 9.825 as Alexa Ebling. Now on to her beam routine for the Hawkeyes. And a great landing, cheers erupting from her teammates. Kept perfect balance.
Staying incredibly tight. She's running through this beam routine. Is a definite beam diva.
Another beautiful landing there from Ebling. Lost her balance just a little bit on that first jump and stuck the next two. As Volpe's score comes in on the beam at 9.8. Great way to start for the Hawkeyes. As Ebling gets ready for a dismount. Feet apart, small hop, but otherwise a great landing. From Ebling, you can see her and her teammates' joy. It was a really high skill level routine.
Her chest was slightly forward. But as I said, a beam queen right there. Smallest hop.
And Kayla Tucker now on the floor for Michigan State. Scored a 9.85. Penn State, again, we see another first pass very quickly for Michigan State, and she sticks that landing. We see Michigan State wasting no time getting right into those passes with this new choreography.
Michigan State's new choreographer has a history with dance, being a dancer and a gymnast, so she knows how to sell this floor routine.
On floor, Buffet, her score came in at 9.875. As Tucker sets up for her second pass. Stumbled just a bit on the landing. But again, when we see these more difficult moves from the Spartans, will happen as she will finish that routine. A really strong floor routine from Tucker.
you can see that a lot of gymnasts struggle doing passes moving forward when one of their first skills they learn is a back handspring, and their sequences at first usually are going backwards, so spotting in the front can be difficult.
Ella Kajuk, some tricky moves, saw that leg stick out there for a bit. Didn't stumble for too long, kept her composure. Going for her jumps.
A gorgeous front walk over back into a scorpion.
Chuck had a 9.9 on Friday against Utah. Very strong performer on the beam.
A little misbalance there again. She's hoping to score higher than a 9.9. With the wobbles taking off, though, she is keeping her composure. However, it will affect her score.
She gets ready for her dismount. A beautiful landing for Juck. Some missed wobbles on the beam, but sticks the landing.
Feet just so ever slightly apart, but she does ultimately look happy with it. She knows she did the best she can, and her skill level will hopefully make up for the couple tenth deductions that she will be receiving.
Gabby Steven now on the floor for Michigan State as Tucker's score came in at a 9.850. Steven, once again, we see the Spartans wasting no time getting to that first pass. Stumbled a little, foot just staying in bounds. Good save by Steven to regain her balance.
Even touching the out-of-bounds lines, you're risking deduction there. Beautiful jump sequence. She is one of the girls tonight that will be executing her new floor skills as warm-ups went good.
Steven gets ready now for her second pass. Take a deep breath. Small stumble there. Feet not quite together there on that landing.
A little bit of an over-rotation from her, but ultimately a beautiful routine.
A great routine for Michigan State, and we see once again, we see with this choreography for the Spartans, they really waste no time getting it right into that first pass, then really showing off the dance skills and that personality. We're finishing
Absolutely.
Off with the pass again as Aubrey Nick for Iowa sets up for her beam routine. The first two beam routines for the Hawkeyes both scoring 9.8s.
A beautiful leap onto the beam right there to get that height, even with the springboard help. You never know what you're gonna get.
Bit of a stumble. Nick scored 9.2 on Friday on the beam against Southern Utah. We'll be looking to score just a bit higher.
Beam is definitely the most rigorous of all of the events in gymnastics.
After that pass, she had a really nice landing, recovering from the small stumble she had earlier. Going for the dismount, and a nice landing. No stumble, feet just a bit apart.
A perfect stick like that, that will help bring your score back up after wobbling slightly.
See the wobble there. Did a great job at getting her composure back quickly. A beautiful landing. She's looking to score hard after struggling on Friday. as Delaney Harkness for Michigan State once again getting right into that first pass. And a nice landing there from Delaney Harkness.
Her hips were completely centered, shoulders nice, and facing forward.
As Steven scoring the same as Buffet on that floor routine with a 9.850.
We know the Spartans came here tonight looking to score with one routine at least a 10 on the floor.
Now we're seeing this choreographed dance portion again. The setup of each MSU routine looking fairly similar, but all doing a great job at showcasing each gymnast's personal style and personality. This gets ready for her second pass. And a great landing. What a sequence of skills there from Harkness to stick the landing and finish strong.
Absolutely beautiful. That front punch really took off. Got great rotation there, great amount of power, and not a single ounce of under-rotating or over-rotating to get that perfect landing like that.
Here we see Marissa Rojas as the score for Nick comes up as a 9.4, so getting a bit higher than her score on Friday, still looking for a bit higher score there from Nick, as you see teammates now encouraging Rojas as she sets up for her routine on the beam. Rojas had a 9.625 on Friday.
Letting the judges know that she is ready.
As we look at scores coming in on the floor, a 9.95 for Harkness. It's the type of score that Mike Rowe and his team was looking for.
A beautiful somersault onto the beam into a candlestick.
Also with Harkness to score that 9.95, that will be her season high. Previously was 9.85. Huge for Delaney Harkness at Michigan State. Legs sticking out a bit there for Rojas, kept her composure quickly.
It's hard when you're going into a three sequence pass like that, but keeping her legs completely straight during it.
Seeing a lot of high level skills presented from either side to top 20 ranked teams. As we see the dismount, almost stuck at a small hop back.
That will be
a good performance from Rojas.
That will be a 10th.
Look here again, see that small wobble, like you said, a three sequence pass. And Nikki Smith always has a lot of fun in her floor routine, showing a lot of passion and sass. Going into that first pass. Got a lot of height and stuck the landing.
This might be the 10 that they're looking for right here if it keeps up like this in the routine.
Smith, her season high, a 9.9. We always see her having a lot of fun out there on the floor. Incredibly talented sophomore. And another perfect stick for Nikki Smith.
She's been working on this very hard. She's bringing everything she's got to the table right now. hitting every beat.
So really important on the floor, keeping that beat and keeping your timing right. We saw her just yesterday in practice working really hard on this floor routine.
Since Simone Biles brought such a unique routine to the Olympics, you've seen girls get more creative with theirs, as I said previously, with rules and regulations, making changes.
And another stick on her third pass. And Smith looking to have a perfect or near perfect score on an amazing floor routine.
Spartan and Hawkeye fans are applauding that floor routine. It's loud up in Jennison Fieldhouse.
Coaches applauding. Get another look at that pass. All three perfect sticks. Keeping great form, getting a lot of good height.
She was warming that up earlier, that backhand spring into the double back. And you could see that she nailed it every time.
And Smith got what she was looking for. The perfect 10 for Michigan State on the floor. As the crowd and team alike erupting, even Hawkeye fans applauding Smith for such an incredible routine. A well-deserved 10 for Nikki Smith.
Maren, I have chills listening to all the cheers, and I know how happy those girls are for their teammate.
That will create a career best and season best for Nikki Smith. Her previous career high on floor was a 9.975, so nearly perfect. And now, just as a sophomore, she gets a perfect 10. What an incredible feat from Nikki Smith. Well deserved after such a great floor routine, beautifully executed. Saw her just over there celebrating with her older sister, Naya. As we head back over to the beam where Karina Munoz steps up for the Hawkeyes.
Excellent needle kick. Leg incredibly straight, toes pointed.
Talked about Munoz getting first place on beam against Minnesota, had a leg kick out there.
We know she didn't score as high as she wanted to though against Southern Utah, and hopefully tonight she will score higher than a 9.775.
She'll go for another pass.
And she'll keep her balance perfectly on that one, making up for the small leg kick out she had earlier.
As we've said all night, it's hard to come back from that kind of stuff, but all these gymnasts here are performing at their max, and that is a perfect landing with just her legs slightly apart.
Strong performance on the beam from Munoz outside that small leg kick out. Legs just a little bit apart on that dismount, but a perfect stick as Skyla Schulte now on the floor for Michigan State. The 9-9 at Penn State, a season high of 9.925, going for her first pass. It's a lot of height and a beautiful landing from Schulte.
Sometimes after that rush of doing a floor pass like that and landing it, you're either really involved in your movement in the routine or you're so focused on hitting that next pass perfectly as you just did before, but you can see she's out there having a beautiful, fun time.
Schulte, like we said, always known for bringing a memorable performance. Like Smith, she had a career high of 9.975 overall in her time at Michigan State. She sets up for her second pass. takes a moment. And another beautiful landing from Schulte.
We might just see two 10s tonight on the floor from Michigan State.
Crowd on their feet here. Like you said, Layla, that could be another perfect 10. That was a beautifully executed floor routine. The Spartans having a lot of fun and really succeeding with this new choreography. These early passes working out well for them, getting it out of the way right there. And a lot of stuck landings, especially coming on these last two from Smith and Schulte. Get another look at that. Beautiful landing.
Incredibly tight features. Excellent power.
And Elise Karenbauer, the last Hawkeye on the beam, starts her routine. So we see applause erupting over at the Michigan State floor. Looking like a 9.95. Not exactly a 10, but still an incredible score and a new season high for Skyla Schulte.
Over here on the beam, we've only had a small bit of struggle to stay balanced, but ultimately beautiful form.
Bauer with a strong landing on that front tuck. Keep your composure on her spins. That's up for her dismount and sticks it just to bend down in her knees a little bit. But what a strong way to finish off for the Hawkeyes.
After with a couple issues on four for her, I'm sure she's thrilled to end her night with a strong beam routine.
So now we'll see our two exhibition gymnasts for Michigan State, starting with Gianna Khalifi. Career high of 9.9 on the floor. We see her get ready for her first pass. Good landing, small stumble.
Bit of a step out there will cost her a 10th, possibly two.
Set up now for her second pass. And a great landing there. Foot just looked like it was on the line, but not out of bounds.
Hopefully that won't affect her score drastically as she is getting super into it. Can tell 100% that this music is catered for her to get in a mindset versus a lyrical opposition. A beautiful step out onto that final pose.
Great exhibition performance there from Khalifi. We've seen it all day long with Michigan State, even in those exhibition gymnast routines, a lot of high-level skills. We've seen some really high-scoring exhibition routines. Don't count toward that final score, but just shows the depth of this Spartan squad.
And it's crucial for them to get into this mindset of competing and to have that opportunity at the meets, as Coach Rowe really wanted to bring attention when we were talking to how he's getting to every single girl individually, making sure that they will be able to next year compete, as the team is not going to be expanding to a larger depth, but he's actually shrinking down the team, possibly only taking in two more girls, but five seniors are graduating, and he's going to lose about seven routines, and he wants to have a strong team where he can give everybody his full attention, and he doesn't have to leave behind girls on the road, as all of them do deserve a chance to shine and step out like this.
And as we see scores come in, Skyla Schulte getting an all-around score of 339.600. That'll match her season best, just a little bit under her career best. Strong performance today from our key player earlier today. Talked a lot about Schulte. She's just a remarkable gymnast, really makes an impact on this team and has in her time as a Spartan as the freshman. Gabby Ortiz sets up for her exhibition routine, the final one we will see here today at Jennison Fieldhouse. Taking a deep breath. You see the score coming from Khalifi's a 9.75. Strong exhibition score for the Spartans as Ortiz starts her routine.
We already have a lot of choreography before heading into that first pass. Those extra moves that are sharper and more consistent with the beat.
Great landing, just a little bit forward there, but a quick recovery from the freshman, as we've seen from her all day, doing her routine with a big smile on her face.
She's truly shaping into a fantastic all-around gymnast. And by this time next year, hopefully we'll be seeing all 10s.
It's her second pass and another great landing. Smallest of stumbles there. Like you said, it'll be great to see how Ortiz develops as a gymnast. Coach Mike Rowe, and seeing her success already just a few meets into the season. A lot of promise in this freshman. Like we said earlier, Big Ten Freshman of the Week, her first conference award. She'll get ready for another pass. And a beautiful stick from Gabby Ortiz.
She's absolutely crushed it all day today. You know she's proud of herself. Her teammates are so proud of her. It's important to have a younger force that's going to start guiding to lead your team in the future as seniors graduate, as people do get picked for worlds and national ranked teams.
And as that finishes up, that will bring us to the end. Our final score is Michigan State 197.4. Iowa falling 195.675. Michigan State dominating. Gabby Steven on the leaderboard at top with a 9.925. Skyla Schulte first in parallel and balance beams, both with a 9.9. Nikki Smith with that perfect 10. And Schulte, we mentioned, tying her season high with a 39.6 in the all-around. What a dominant performance for the Spartans here at their home opener and on Alumni Day. Great to see so many alumni that came out to support the team, and the team showed up for those alumni.
Absolutely, especially with us being ranked both with Iowa and Michigan State, it was bound to be a great match.
The final score for Ortiz came in as a 9.775. As we'll look at beam for the Hawkeyes, Volpe with a 9.8, Ebling with a 9.8, Juck with a 9.725, Aubrey Nick a 9.525, Rojas 9.650, and Munoz with a 9.775. Strong performance on the beams, but could not put the Hawkeyes past the Spartans, and especially after such a dominant floor rotation from Michigan State, we see Ellie Buffet with a 9.875, Tucker 9.85, Steven 9.85, Harkness with that 9.950, Nikki Smith a perfect 10, and Schulte with a 9.950. Such a dominant performance on floor from Michigan State as they've had all year, and a great way to come back into Jennison Fieldhouse to open up for the 2024 season at home. We're going to send it down now to Owen Ozust with Nikki Smith, who got that perfect 10.
Thanks, guys. Nikki,
You just had a perfect 10 on floor. You set the MSU record. How does it feel?
It feels amazing. I just went out there and did my best, showed everybody like how hard I've been working. And when I heard it was the first 10 on floor, all I could say was that was crazy. It was fun.
What was going through your mind as you hit that? Did you know it was going to be a 10?
I knew it was going to be a pretty good score after my last pass. Just so much excitement was going through my head after I hit my last pass.
And Sarah Sageman, who previously had the record, I interviewed her earlier, and I asked her, is there anyone on this team that could break this record? And she listed you. What does it mean for these alumni to come back and to be a part of this team and watch you guys?
It means so much to be a part of Team 50, and it means so much that all the alumni, a lot of the alumni, have came to watch us today. They have set a great path for all of us, and yeah.
And Team 50, I know it's early, but what is this team's identity?
This team's identity is, I'd say, we are dogs, and we're ready for anything, and we're not done yet.
Thank you so much. All right, now we're going to send it over to Lexi, who has Skyla Schulte waiting for us.
I'm here with Big Ten Gymnast of the Week, Skyla Schulte. Skyla, just tell me about that award and what it means to receive it.
I would say it just kind of recognizes the hard work that I put in every week. And also, though, the team, it's not just me, it's a team effort, so that too.
There was so much support in the stands today. I mean, friends, family, athletes from other teams. What does that support mean, and does that play into your performance?
It means a lot. Just them showing up and taking time to be here, it does mean a lot, and it just shows the love they have.
Your next meet is against Michigan, an obvious rivalry there. What does the preparation look like going into that?
I would say it's about the same as every week. We're just trying to hone in on details, landings, really getting those little details that we try to work on every week. But also, we're friends with Michigan, so it's like it's a good rivalry, but they're great girls. They're very sweet.
Thank you so much, Skyla. I won't keep you. Go ahead and celebrate with your team.
Thank you.
This has been Gymnastics on Big Ten Plus. Now to Owen.
Thank you so much, Lexi and Owen, and a big congrats to Nikki and Skyla for such dominant performances. We're going to send it to a break, but stay right with us. We have awards coming soon here on Big Ten Plus.
Spartan fans, please turn your attention to the floor as we welcome back former Michigan State gymnast to Jennison Fieldhouse as we celebrate 50 seasons of Spartan gymnastics. Fans, please welcome back from the class of 1970, Jill Campbell Mason. From 1999, Mary Jo Ferris. From 2005, Diana Wamakia. From 1988, Gail Sawchuk. From 1996, Heather Cooper Kim. From 1980, Diane Lovato Culbertson. From 2021, Tristan Brown. From 2006, Sarah Sageman. From 2019, Jessica Lane. From 2003, Deanna Vogel. From 1989, Kim Reinich. From 1990, Christy Burns. From 2010, your Spartan assistant coach, Nicole Curler-Jones. And from the class of 2005, Kristen Buttes. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give these young ladies a great Spartan round of applause for coming back for the 50 years of Spartan gymnastics. Again, Mariah Smith. Mariah Smith, please report to the head table.
ladies and gentlemen, we are ready for today's awards ceremony. Presenting today's awards are former Michigan State gymnast.
Hello and welcome back Diana into Jenison Bobo. Fieldhouse, Michigan State, winning this meet 197.400 to 195.700. We're going to send it down to the awards on the floor.
Place, a tie with 9.875 from Iowa, Avery Chambers. Also in third place with a 9.875 from Michigan State University, Michaela Tucker. In second place with a 9.9 from Michigan State University, Sage Kellerman. Our vault champion today with a 9.925 from Michigan State University, Gabby Stephen. Congratulations to our vault champions today. Ladies, please salute. On the bars in third place with a 9.850 from Michigan State University, Nikki Smith. A tie for first place on the bars with a 9.9 from Michigan State University, Delaney Harkness. Also with a 9.9 on the bars from Michigan State University, Skyla Shelty. Congratulations to our bar champions this afternoon. Ladies, please salute. On the beam, a two-way tie for second place with a 9.825 from Michigan State University, Gabby Ortiz. Also in second place with a 9.825 from Michigan State University, Gianna Califi. Our beam champion today with a 9.9 from Michigan State University, Skyla Shelty. Congratulations to our beam champions this afternoon. Ladies, please salute. On the floor, a two-way tie for second place with a 9.950 from Michigan State University, Skyla Shelty. Also with a 9.95 from Michigan State University, Delaney Hopness. Our four champion today with a perfect 10.0 from Michigan State University, Nikki Smith. Congratulations to our four champions today. Ladies, please salute. In the all-around competition, in third place with a 39.175 from Iowa, Ava Volpe. In second place with a 39.350 from Michigan State University, Gabby Stephen. Our all-around champion this afternoon with a 39.6 from Michigan State University, Skyla Shelty. Congratulations to our all-around champions this afternoon. Ladies, please salute. In second place this afternoon with a 190.
So that will do it here at Jenison, Michigan State, picking up a big home win, celebrating their 50th anniversary of the program. Big performances of Skyla Shelty getting that all-around record, and Nikki Smith getting the perfect 10, the team's second of the season, just in a few meets, an incredibly impressive feat.
Absolutely.
Congratulations.
Tonight's been fantastic to watch. All the girls, an excellent job, great technique, and we'll see how they do staying ranked in the top 20.
So from everyone here at Michigan State, me alongside Lila Pascal with Lexi Alston and Owen Ozis on the floor, our producer Alexa Wolkwitz, and our directors Matt McCullum, Victoria Irish, and all of our crew here in East Lansing, thank you so much. You've been watching Big Ten Gymnastics on Big Ten Plus.
Please drive home safely. As always, go green.